Hi, in this video we're going to be talking about how to subtract decimals up to three decimal places, as well as how to estimate decimals and solve it in your head quickly just to make sure your answer is correct. So here I've got a place value chart, and we have a question here. It says subtract 0.547 from 5. So 5 is a whole number in the ones column. So I've rewritten it here. So let's draw it out. So I need 5 ones. So I am going to just do them as dots. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here's my 5 ones. I need to take away 5 from here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I need to take 4 from here. 1, 2, 3, 4. I need to take 7 from here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh, sorry. 5, 6, 7. So that's what I need to do. If you notice though, I've actually got no dots in my tens, no dots in my hundreds, no dots in my thousands. So how am I gonna take away 5? Sorry, accidentally, I've got to remember my tallies. How am I gonna take away 5 from here, 4 from here, 7 from here when there isn't any? Well, I'm gonna actually need to regroup. So let's do that. How we do it is I need to take one of these and bring it over here. What is one whole number in the ones column worth in my tenths column? Well, it's worth 10, because I'm breaking up into 10 parts. So if I move this one over to here, I actually have to write it as 10 dots. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Remember, when we're subtracting, we always need to go from the one that's furthest to the right. So I actually can't start subtracting yet because I've still got nothing in here. So I'm going to need to get one of these dots and move it over here. What is 1/10 represented as 1/100? It's worth 10. So I'm just going to rub out my one dot here and rewrite it as 10/100. So there's my 10 dots representing one of these. Yeah. And then again, I need to do this thousandth. So 1/100 is worth 10/1000. They're worth the same. So I'm just rewriting it. So cross it out. Now I got 10 in here. All right, now finally, if I zoom in, we can see very clearly that I've written 5. Yeah, I've written my 5 just in a funny way. I've written it as 4 ones, 9/10, 9/100, and 10/1000. It's another way of just writing 5 dots here. It's actually worth the exact same. It's just me showing it in a different way. Now I can start subtracting. So I want to take away 7. I might just change my color here so it does not get confusing. Actually, maybe I'll do a highlighter. I'm just going to highlight the ones that I want. So I'm going to cross out 7. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I need to take away 4 from the hundredths. 1, 2, 3, 4. I need to take 5 from the tenths. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So what's my final answer? I can now write it down. By the way, while I'm changing my pen, you always, there's two methods of really doing this. I'm showing you the visual way, and then I'll show you the easy way. So I've got my 4 ones left. I've got 4/10. Don't forget my decimal place right here. So I've got 4/10. I've got 5/100 here. And I've got 3/1000. So my answer is 4.453. That is what 5 take away by 0.547 is. Here's the second method, which is the vertical subtraction method. So I'm just going to go simply 5 take away 0 point. So here I need to put in my decimals. 547. So up here, it'll be helpful if I do zeros so that I have my place value right. I've got my tenths, I've got my hundredths, got my thousandths. Now I can go 0 take away 7. Oh, can't do. So I've got to go to make this 0 bigger. Oh, I can't take away 1 from here. Oh, can't take away from here. Oh, I can. So I cross out my 5, make it a 4. This becomes 10. I'm still trying to make this work right now. So I need to move over across. So I'm going to now go, I'm going to make that 10 into 9. And now this becomes 10. I'm still wanting this one to be bigger. So I'm going to cross this out and make that 9 and make this 10. I've now got it big enough to take away 7. So I don't need to cross it out anymore. So 10 take away 7 is 3. 9 take away 4 is 5. 9 take away 5 is 4. Don't forget your decimal. 4 take away nothing is still 4. So my answer is 4.453. It's the same answer. So that would be how I do it, vertical method. Last step is what to do with estimation. So let's go back to, let's go to a different question, here's my question. I could have 5.326 take away 3.78. So let's say that's my question. Instead of having to write it vertically or do it with the place value and draw it up, I could do what we call an estimation. So if I do a little line like this, it's an equal sign, but squiggly, just means I want to estimate. So I'm just saying estimating 5.3 is actually just close to 5. And 3.78 is actually close to 4. How'd I do that? Well, I remember that when rounding, anything between 0 and 4, you want to round down or just keep the same. Anything from 5 to 9, you round up, and it means you go one higher. So I'm looking at my my first tenths column here, and just looking at the 3 and the 7. So for my 3, I go, well, it's in here, so I'm going to keep it, this number, as 5. For my next number, I saw 7 is in this category, so I need to round up. So I had to change this 3 now to 4. So 5 estimated take away 4 is 1. So I know my answer should be roughly 1. So now if I actually do it, so that was 5.326 take away 3.78. I put in a 0 so it makes it easier. So 12 take away 8 is 4. 12 take away 7 is 12. 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5. It's 5, 4. So my answer is 1.546. Is that close to 1? Yeah, it is. It's only half a number higher. So that is how I estimate. Great. Hope you've learned something today.